At the same time that Great Zimbabwe and the Swahili coast were flourishing in East Africa, civilizations in West Africa were igniting an artistic revolution. Today, Benin City is part of Nigeria, completely rebuilt after it was burned and looted by Britain's invading army in 1897. But at its peak, it was at the center of a kingdom that controlled over 20,000 square miles. And at its heart sat the royal palace of the Oba, the king. The sublime art that Benin's artists created reveals an urban society that was both complex and sophisticated. These treasures of classic world art are known today as the Benin Bronzes.
When I look at that, I see a brother with dreadlocks wearing a turtleneck. What do you see, art historian?
That's a great commentary on it. It's an idealized portrait of one of the kings of Benin. And the dreadlocks, as you are calling them, are actually strings of coral.
What was the function of the head of the Oba?
Well, these were placed on a royal altar in the middle of the palace. Each king, once he died, had an altar made for him. Mm-hmm. They would have been made by a patron who would have been a later king, honoring his predecessor. Mm.
The man chiefly responsible for initiating this artistic tradition was a 15th century Oba known as Ewuare the Great. According to oral tradition, Ewuare seized power from his brother after years of civil war.
Ewuare the Great is one of these remarkable figures in human history who is seen to have done a lot for the kingdom. There are many traditions that are credited back to his reign. I think one of the most important is that he rebuilds the city and a palace in it.
From the year 900, the Edo people had begun to carve a home out of the West African rainforest. The people remained within small village chiefdoms, but over time, a centralized city-state emerged that by the 15th century was about to undergo a remarkable transformation. When Ewuare became Oba in 1440, he ordered an extraordinary engineering project to rebuild the city as a stronghold from which he could expand his kingdom.
Benin had a very elaborate system of earthworks that went not just around the city itself, as you might expect, but all throughout the countryside too. I think it's the longest earthwork system in the entire world.
Estimated to be longer than the Great Wall of China, the walls encompassed over 500 surrounding villages and have been called the world's largest ancient monument. Their purpose was not only to keep out enemies, but to keep out the forest as well.
Boundaries are very important in many indigenous West African societies. In Benin, there's a sense in which the space of human settlement was maintained through constant work to keep the forest at bay.
But for Ewuare the Great, the city's walls serve still another purpose.
What's interesting about all of those earthworks around Benin is that their purpose is to keep people from moving anywhere except through designated areas. You couldn't go anywhere in Benin without passing through a gate, and there would be a guard there, and he would inquire about your business and so on. So everything was channeled through this very elaborate bureaucracy.
Benin City became a military fortress. Residents unhappy with Ewuare's restructuring of Benin society